3 years ago, Delilah was laying her plans. The Duke's people gathered at the home of a mine baron named Aramis Stilton to commit some horror in her name. I need to know how they made her immortal. But where was I 3 years ago, letting Emily daydream through council meetings, teaching her fencing and back alley fighting? I always expected an enemy we could put down with a sword. Soldiers, spies, assassins. Instead, we got something else, beyond the pale, beyond the natural world. Instead, we got hit by someone like me.
Out in the city, but I'll explain.
I need to know why Delilah can't be killed. Everything we've learned implies that something strange happened at Aramis Stilton's home 3 years ago, but then he disappeared.
Stilton lived in a bunker kept secure by a fancy lock made by Jindosh. Maybe inside you'll learn more about how to stop Delilah.
But I have to get there first, through a ruin created by the Duke, where I used to live.
Megan had an intriguing idea. Howlow is leader of the Howlers. He wants Vice Overseer Byrne killed, and of course, Byrne wants Paolo dead too. Both groups will attack you on sight, but walk in with the corpse of their chief enemy, and they'll treat you like family.
So that gives me at least one way into Aramis Stilton's house.
I'm pretty sure that will work.
Coming back here, seeing it changed, run into the ground. Some people have reached beyond others.
As I can.
I didn't know Aramis Stilton. Who was he?
Loyal to the old Duke. Stilton helped build modern Karnaca with those silver mines. Worked his way up from nothing to a fortified mansion. But the new Duke spends money so fast. The mine crews work all day and all night. The district's in ruins. The dust drives out anyone except the most desperate.
The Duke of Cirkonos has made a mess of things. His father was a good man.
True, but the new Duke's misery has only been possible with Dunwall's support. In any case, you'll have to pass through the dust district. Maybe Stilton's still in there. Or maybe he's dead. Find Megan once you reach the Dust District. She'll tell you more. I'll wait here with the skiff. Take you back to the Dreadful Whale after you finish.
Dust District anymore.
Orders from the Duke.
No way!
Someone's shooting at us!
Around here.
I wonder who that was.
Silver dust out of my ears. Grand Palace. That's an assignment. Waffles and slippers. What was that?
This is
what? Someone. Ah!
This hit.
Storm coming.
won't just leave the district. And the Howlers. Hello, Lord Protector. I've been doing reconnaissance. Talking to people. The Overseers and the Howlers have divided up the district. Just ahead is neutral territory where no one will harass you. But further on, the Howlers and the Overseers both have boundaries set up. And beyond those points, they'll attack you on sight.
Aramis Stilton is the real goal. Sokolov said you'd worked out a plan.
Yes. I believe that if you take out Paolo or Vice Overseer Byrne, the other one will grant you safe passage and will help you get inside Stilton's home. Neutralize either one of them and bring him to the other.
Got anything else?
Byrne is protected by the Overseers. Paolo has the Howlers, but I think he's also got some kind of black magic charm. They say he's got to die twice before the sun sets, or he can't be killed. Good luck with that.
City. I'm not sure why Stilton's house needed to be shut up.
Never mind. Maybe another time.
Or not. Let's go.
That. Vice Overseer hasn't shared his plans with me. He's upstairs now, so I assume we'll learn something before long.
I'd wager it'll all be over soon. I'm surprised it's taken us this long to deal with a mob of ruffians.
You know what the strictures say about wagering, brother? The Howlers are merciless, and Paolo carries the Outsider's blessing. Some talismans come straight from the jaws of the Void itself. Keep that in mind, or you'll find yourself bleeding out in some alley.
Forgive me, Brother Mikos.
That we unite against the spirits of the unknown that would drag us screaming into the night, never to return.
We accounted for six of them.
If I have to go, it warms my spirit to spend my last minutes with a true friend.
You honor me. I wish there was another way, but it's a gut wound, as bad as any I've seen. Better this than a day or two of agony.
Then I go, and I keep the stretchers close to my... May there be no discord in my spirit.
Dozens of overseers have died trying to bring Paolo down. We've struck him fatal injuries, and somehow he comes back the next day to fight again. Whatever witchcraft he has, even the ancient music is ineffective.
I believe Paolo is in possession of some unclean artifact.
Burn.
It's my fear that he has to be killed twice in one day.
And the Duke won't help?
The Duke is no friend of ours. He exiled me from the Grand Palace, and he's done everything possible to push the Abbey of the Everyman of Cirkonos. The look on his face when he dismissed me from court. There's something wrong with people who are in the palace.
They go. Even Phil.
So. still taste that hag flesh.
Maybe she's right.
I've been trying to bring Burn down for months. You did what others couldn't.
And now you owe me, Paolo.
We've been at war with the Abbey, not just over territory, but over the people of Karnaca as well. This is my home. And I'm gonna send Burn to Dunwall without his hands, to explain things to the High Overseer and the Empress herself. Bet you didn't see this coming, Vice Overseer. Now, what is it you want?
I need to get inside Aramis Stilton's house.
You're intriguing, and maybe more dangerous than most who darken my doorway.
I advise you to remember it.
Here's what you'll need to enter the house.
Regardless of what happens in Karnaca, remember where you came from. Acquit yourself better than the Duke has.
You can count on that, friend. The Duke's a worthless buffoon. Get this guy out of here. Over the balance in Karnaca. Now the tide is turning.
I'll be there.
What's going on here?
Here you are.
You've been living a soft life. I'll cut you in half.
Think you look tough?
You shouldn't have worn your
belt.
In the mood. Show yourself.
What?
Wait. Look. I think his hand is worth a fortune. Let's see what you got.
No, you
no!
I'll be taking it. I'll...
This one is wrong.
You're gonna pay for his death.
Hand.
case you're wondering, Paolo's not one of those unhinged cultists who believe I will grant them favors if they leave a big enough offering or play just the right musical notes. He doesn't care a fig for me. But he put up this shrine because he found the hand of an old witch I knew once. And Paolo saw right away that it pays to have an edge. Sometimes, pieces of us linger long after we're gone. The Duke of Cirkonos inherited a vibrant city and wasted no time stripping it to the bone. What will he leave behind? And what about you? Who will you leave to pick up the pieces here in the Jewel of the South?
Thank you.
Oh.
He denounced his own pride as a hair taken on leave.
Safer
he brought him in for interrogation. Downtrodden, the poor and forgotten, mudlocks, beggars, and orphans. Who speaks for them? His grandfather was devoted to the Abbey, so this overseer calmly recited the seven strictures as he choked the old man to death. The smallest misstep, and he will suspect you are in league with the outsider. Every one of them suffers from an errant mind. He hates them for it. And once they confess to that, the rest is easy.
My pistol! I wonder who that was. I will find you, you know. That was a rat. It was a fat one. Someone there.
Nice.
I'll have a look around. Ugh!
I think I just saw something. I know an agent of the Outsider when I see one.
Oh!
Job. Stilton made sure of it. No one got fired for being injured.
Oh, yeah, so they say.
I'm in.
The mother got in and things like that. And the family committee made sure that the boss.
Guard won't like that.
That's it. The information was good.